Thank you, Christy. So hello again. For those of you who weren't on earlier, I'm Brenda Karkus, and I'll be presenting Section O, Special Treatments, Procedures, and Programs. I am a registered nurse with experience in direct patient care, education, and nursing administration. And my experience includes inpatient care, outpatient oncology, home health, and hospice settings. And currently, I'm an associate at Apt Associates in Cambridge. So I'll just start by explaining the implications for each setting for this item, O0110. So for the IRF setting, this is a completely new item. And this is a bit different for LTEC because LTEC, there were already some data elements for O0110. However, most of these data elements are also completely new for the LTEC setting. One element that was in the LCDS was 0110N, total parenteral nutrition, and this has now been removed. So the intent of these items in this section is to identify any special treatments, procedures, and programs that apply to the patient on admission and then again on discharge. And this is just a screenshot of the items with all the procedures and treatments listed that would be checked on both admission and discharge. And the actual item set has a column A for admission and column C for discharge. And just for your reference, hopefully you're following along with your own item set, but this item is located on page 16 and 17 for the IRF-PAI and on pages 21 and 22 for the LCDS. So here's our first practice scenario for O0110. This patient was discharged from the hospital following an acute care inpatient stay for pneumonia. On admission to post-acute care setting, the patient requires continuous oxygen and IV antibiotics for 5 days through a peripheral line, in addition to some respiratory therapy for chest PT. Now let's go to our first polling question. So how would you code 0110 for this patient? Is it A, C2 continuous, H3 antibiotics, and O2 peripheral, or B, C1 oxygen therapy, C2 continuous, H1 IV medications, and H3 antibiotics, or C, C1, C2, H1 medications, H3 antibiotics, O1 IV access, and O2 peripheral? Or is it D, C1, H1 IV medications, and O1 IV access? And I'll give you a few more minutes to consider that and respond to the poll. So it looks like most of you checked C, and if you did, that answer was correct. 65% of you chose the answer C. So you would check oxygen therapy, continuous, the IV medications, as well as antibiotics, IV access, and O2 peripheral. And here's the rationale. On admission, this patient is receiving the continuous oxygen, has a peripheral IV line, and is also receiving IV antibiotics. Okay, so now let's look at practice scenario number two. This patient was admitted to a PAC facility after being discharged from an acute care hospital following a pathologic vertebral fracture related to osteoporosis. While hospitalized, the patient was also transfused with 2 units of PAC red blood cells to treat a new diagnosis of severe anemia. At the time of admission, the referral documentation and physician orders only include pain medication with tramadol, anti-osteoporotic medications, and physical therapy. Lab work to evaluate the anemia is scheduled to be repeated in 2 days. So now let's look at a polling question. How would you code O0110 for this patient? Is it A, H10, other, and I1 transfusions? Is it just I1 transfusions? Or is it Z, none of the above? I'll give you a few seconds to answer that. Okay, so it looks like most of you, more than half of you, answered Z, none of the above, and that would be the correct answer. And let's look at the rationale for that. So this patient is receiving medications for pain and osteoporosis. Physical therapy is also ordered. However, neither medication is being given IV, and PT is not listed under special treatments, procedures, and programs. So the transfusion that occurred is in the past, and it's not currently included in her orders either. So therefore, the response would be Z1, none of the above. That's the best answer. Okay, how about practice scenario number 3? This patient was admitted to a PAC facility after surgery for a fractured hip. They have a history of sleep apnea and have been independent with their CPAP device for many years. Due to the mobility issues, the staff will need to set up the humidifier element of the CPAP for this patient. However, the patient can put on the mask independently at bedtime. The admission orders include oral medications for high blood pressure, high cholesterol, and an anticoagulant in addition to PT. I'll give you some time to consider this, and then we can move on to the question. So how would you code 0110 for this patient? Is it A, F1, invasive mechanical ventilator, and H10, other, under medications? B, G1, non-invasive mechanical ventilator, and H10, other, under medications? Or C, G1, and also G3 CPAP, or G1, H4 anticoagulation, and H10 other. Okay, I think we can close. So it looks like most of you went between C and D, but the majority, 63%, answered C, which is the correct answer. Excellent. And the rationale is that although this patient is on an anticoagulant, O110 H4 anticoagulation is not checked because this is given orally and not through the IV for this patient. They're also currently using the CPAP machine at bedtime. So G1 for this item may be checked if the patient places or removes their own CPAP, or even if the staff applies it for the patient. And you would also check G3 for the CPAP. Okay, here's a continuation of this very same patient in scenario number 3. This patient did well with rehab and was independently ambulating with a cane for safety. However, just prior to discharge from the facility stay, an infection developed at the surgical site, resulting in a need for IV antibiotics. The patient still wished to return home as planned, so the peripheral line was replaced with a heparin lock to maintain access for the last 4 doses of IV antibiotics. Discharge to home with a local home health agency was arranged and included orders for the CPAP, IV antibiotics, as well as the oral medications for high blood pressure, high cholesterol, and the anticoagulant. So how would you code 0110 for this patient on discharge? Is it A, G1 non-invasive mechanical ventilator and H1 IV medications, or B, G1, G3 CPAP and H3 antibiotics, or C, G1, H1 IV meds, H3 antibiotics and H4 anticoagulant, or D, G1, G3 CPAP, H1 IV medications, H3 antibiotics, O1 IV access, and O2 peripheral. Please take a few seconds to answer that poll. Okay, I think we can close the poll. All right, so it looks like most of you, 75%, answered D, which is actually the correct answer. And the rationale is that O0110 H3 antibiotics is checked because this is given IV. The oral medications are not checked. This patient is still using the CPAP machine at bedtime, so you would check G1 and G3 for the CPAP. And in addition, the patient's returning home with a peripheral line, so you would also check O1 and O2 peripheral. Okay, so let's go through one more practice scenario, number four. This patient was admitted to the LTEC facility after an acute care hospitalization related to chest pain and difficulty swallowing. The diagnosis was esophageal cancer. They were discharged to your facility with orders for radiation and IV chemo via a central line. The medications are carboplatin and paclitaxel. There are also orders for physical therapy to improve strength and function and promote as much independence as possible. So in this scenario, how would you code O0110 for this patient? Is it A, A1 chemotherapy, A2 IV, B1 radiation, O1 IV access, and O4 central? Or B, both A1 chemotherapy and A2 IV? Or C, A1, A2 IV, and H1 IV medications? Or D, A1, A2 IV, B1 radiation, H1 IV medications, O1 IV access, and O4 central? I'll give you a few seconds to consider that. Okay, I think we can close the poll. And it looks like most of you answered D. However, the answer is A. A1 chemotherapy, A2 IV, B1 radiation, O1 IV access, and O4 central would be checked. And the rationale for this is the patient is currently receiving IV chemotherapy via a central line in addition to the radiation. The IV access would also be checked along with the route, a central line. IV medication is included in the chemotherapy response, so you would not check IV medication. Physical therapy would not be included since it is not a choice in this item. And just a few key insights to close on coding section O. Complete O0110 items as close to the admission and discharge as possible. Services provided solely in conjunction with a surgical procedure or a diagnostic procedure should not be included, such as an IV medication. Medication should be evaluated to determine its route and the reason for use before coding. Bilevel positive airway pressure, a BiPAP or a CPAP may be coded if the patient places or removes their own mask. And IV medication and blood transfusions administered during chemotherapy are not recorded under O0110 H1 IV medications. So thank you for your attention and hope you enjoyed these coding scenarios today.